We shall now go on to our next speaker, Dr. Ragini Parekh, who's an extremely prolific surgeon heading the ophthalmic department of JJI Hospital. Has performed innumerable record-breaking numbers of surgeries, a very popular ophthalmologist of the country, an eminent figure of Maharashtra State Society, has brought out top-notch BOA conferences, attracting huge number of ophthalmologists and great scientific content. So let's hear from you, Dr. Ragini.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, Dr. Chitra, ma'am, Chitra Didi, for having me here for this lovely ARC meet with, I think, one of the topmost SICS surgeons from all over India. Only you could bring all of them together. Thank you so much for this wonderful meet. Good afternoon, senior
Ragini teacher. Ragini, ma'am, can you mute the other presentation in the Bombay one, ma'am?
Yeah, it's muted. My thing is not running from Mumbai because it's band.
Okay.
Sorry. Thank you, Satyaji. Back and came back. Thank you, Satyaji. Sorry. So my phone is off because I need to concentrate on this. Dr. Chitra, ma'am, will you please share my presentation?
Mr. Sunil, can you show Dr. Agni's video?
So good afternoon, respected friends, teachers, friends, colleagues, and everybody who are advocates of SICS surgery, which is the need of the hour today. Thank you so much. So as the name suggests over here, you can see over here, this is the most important step in an SICS surgery, that is making of the conjunctival flap. Because the flap needs to be reposited back properly so that the patient doesn't have any foreign body sensation. This is the tunnel. The construction of the tunnel, which is a funnel-shaped incision in SICS, is extremely important. It is essentially a sclerocorneal tunnel with a modified frown incision. And as you can see, you are using the correct set of instruments. This is the crescent blade to make the tunnel. And as you can see over here, the pockets are being made correctly. This is now extending the incision, as you can see over here, with a keratome. The internal incision is bigger than the external incision. As you can see over here, this is a cataracta nigra. And I would not do phaco in such a patient because I would be very scared. A sheet's glide is nothing, as we all know, but a polypropylene disposable sheet. And when the nucleus comes out, you thank yourself that you did not go with phaco, but it can be easily removed with SICS. And hence, I would say that there are no contraindications for SICS surgery, or very few. This is the AC maintainer, which is put, and there is some amount of cortex, but it can be removed. Some amount of cortex can be removed before or after the surgery, depending on your comfort. And if you feel that the lens will provide a buttress to prevent any complication occurring, then you can put in the lens and then remove. Placing the conjunctiva back is very, very important, because on the second day, the patient does not have any foreign body sensation and it seals the wound. As you can see over here, this is a second patient with a large corneal opacity and a complicated cataract with posterior cyanicate. So you go ahead with making a tunnel and opening up the pupil, which is very, very important if we have to do a capsulotomy of any sort. You can use a needle or any instrument to open up the pupil gently. These irises are very, very friable, and one has to be very careful not to injure them, otherwise they start bleeding. And then once the pupil is opened, you can do a capsulotomy. After that, the tunnel is opened and then you go ahead with the surgery. Now here the patient has a central corneal opacity in the pupillary area, which would definitely affect your visibility during phacoemulsification. And the small dilated pupil would allow you to do phaco only in that small zone. I was very comfortable doing SICS in this patient. And as you can see over here, the nucleus is rotated and brought out into the anterior chamber. Once the nucleus is in the anterior chamber, then it is a little easier because, the main difficulty here was also bringing the nucleus out in the anterior chamber because you could not see much to the undilated pupil. Then doing the nucleus delivery with a glide over here and then doing the cortex aspiration. I'm sorry that because of the lack of time, we could not show the complete cortex aspiration, but we always do cortex aspiration with the AC maintainer and the irrigation with the AC maintainer and aspiration with the Lahne modified cannula, which Dr. Bimindhal taught us, which is very, very safe. Thank you so much.
Wonderful surgeries, very gracefully shown, and the way you made your incisions, all very, very amazing. Now, these large incisions would induce a surgical-induced astigmatism. Now, the way I've been seeing a very good SICS surgery is done, and some of y'all would be confidently putting multifocal lenses also into it and doing everything most optimally. It is just another way of handling a cataract beautifully. So when there is so much of SICA which is likely, Tamil, I wanted to ask you, if these surgeons would want to use the Barrett's formula, would they? How would they feed in for that centroid value?
Actually, for phacoemulsification, we have this Dr. Warrenhill's website where we have to enter at least minimum of 20 to 25 cases done through the same incision size, either superior or temporal. And it is there for mean SIA and also for centroid SIA. There's an Excel sheet where you have to enter the pre-op K values and the post-op refraction, and it will calculate the centroid value and it will provide it.
Okay. Dr. Deepak Mehgul, would you want to add anything on that?
Nothing, ma'am. I think Dr. Ragini Matt's presentation was excellent. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yeah. The first case which she showed was, you know, where it was a black cataract. I think where we, most of us would want to go into SICS. My additions would be like, I would not hesitate to use better viscoelastic in such cases, like a cohesive viscoelastic for creating some space when you want to deliver the nucleus out. And before that, I would preferably use something like viscoat to coat the endothelium. So it is these devices or these OVDs are not exclusive to phaco. I think they do a great job even in SICS. For all black cataracts or all, these have a great role in SICS, which I just wanted to emphasize because the results are outstanding when we use these devices. So SICS does not necessarily mean it has to be very economical, very cheap, because cornea, as we know, the endothelium is, the damage is irreversible, obviously. So that is the reason why I would just add that extra safety margin by using these viscoelastics. They do a great job.
Yes, very well said, Dr. Deepak ji. Very well said. Very true. And one thing which he said and which Madam started off this discussion with is the astigmatism. So what I would like to say is that the incision in the black cataract would be a little bigger than your small posterior polar cataract. But, you know, when I consider the risk of doing a phaco, having a nucleus drop, compromising the endothelium. And as Deepak ji said, very truly, that when I was learning from Dr. Lahne, sir, he told me only one thing, that treat the cornea like God, because you are not going to be able to replace the endothelial cells. They do not regrow or regenerate. And so that if I get a little bit of astigmatism, it's okay then, rather than having a compromised endothelium, which may look okay in the first 1 or 2 months, but a few years later, the patient will decompensate. And also not to have a nucleus drop or complications in these black cataracts. So I would compromise on getting a little bit of astigmatism and not the complications.
Since I see there is little more iris manipulations in some of the SICS cases, which is necessary to probably, do some of y'all add some subconjunctival injection or a subtenon steroid or something like that, or it's not necessary? Yes, yes, Ragini.
Yes, so, you know, the very important thing is that you have to customize each and every case. The iris handling comes into the picture, like in visco expression, which I do, if you pull before the nucleus is engaged. So, you know, to bring the nucleus out in the anterior chamber and to decide which case you want to do SICS, like if it is a non-dilating pupil. Of course, once the iris comes out, then it doesn't stop. So, you know, you have to like in it, it's the technique is different, like SICS and FACO. But if you have a small non-dilating pupil, then everything that you would do in FACO, you can also use in SICS to keep the pupil safe, to prevent it from being little friable and all. So the technique, only the tunnel is different. The nucleus delivery is different, but you can deal with and you can tackle the pupil with all the techniques and all the devices that you use in a small pupil.
Yes, yes. I agree. Totally agree.
One point, ma'am. Quick one point.
Yes, doctor.
Yeah. As far as like a large and hard nucleus is concerned, you can simply extend your tunnel. And if you want to control the astigmatism, you can put one or two sutures. This is the simplest way. I agree with the Dr. Deepak. But sometimes, most of times, even with sutures, you can put control SIA below 0.5. So these are the few modifications and it can be worked without so many things.
Ragini ma'am, we saw you only putting a glide and removing the nucleus. You don't use a second instrument?
So this is the Blumenthal technique where there is an AC maintainer at 6 o'clock. And then the glide is put over the iris, under the nucleus, but not too much into the anterior chamber. Because if you put it too much into the anterior chamber, once the nucleus comes out, there will be a PC which will hit right away. So only the AC maintainer, which also helps with the fluid flow to help the nucleus glide out. And you have to rotate your eyeball a little down. You can either use the superior rectus, or what sir does is that to fix the eyeball and rotate it slightly down to help the glide. And you have to use pressure and counter pressure to allow the fluid to help the nucleus to glide out. Dr. Lani sir, would you like to?
Yes, yes. What Satyajit is asking, is any other instrument used? No. Other yes. instrument is not used. Yes, there is a forceps that is used. By the forceps, what I do is just press the lower lip of the sclera. And once you buy the glide only, and that opens, and by the hydro expression, it comes out by the pressure of the fluid, it comes out. But the second thing what Sudhir was saying, when the tunnel is more than 5 millimeter, it is always better to take one suture. So if it is more than 5.5, two sutures. If it is more than 6, three sutures. It is always better to have the sutures, and this suture will definitely prevent astigmatism. So if you can go for the larger incision, yes, you can go for larger tunnel, but suture is must. Go for the suture.
One point I want to add, we can have back cuts or radial cuts, I should say, and then scleral pockets that will help also delivery of nucleus.
But yes, you are correct. Very correct, because the back cuts, it is called two back cuts because nucleus is also having the thickness. So yeah, these back cuts will definitely help.
And with we scleral do the back pockets. Cuts
because we have modified that frown incision. Okay.
Yes, sir. So, Chayan, sir, you are very correct. In each and every patient, we have a modified frown incision with 100% scleral pockets that maintains the internal incision larger than the external incision, allowing the nucleus to be delivered and also allowing your astigmatism to be controlled. That's an absolute must. You are absolutely correct.
Thank you very much.